Sunday afternoon, and we are looking at some pretty dry weather over the next few days. Only a slim chance of some showers coming back, and we're to the point where we could use some rain. We're not quite to drought yet, but if you think about how wet August was by comparison, that 6.87 inches through the 28th was the 11th wettest on record in Birmingham. And you think in August, there were places in Blount and St. Clair counties that had well over a foot of rain. Since then, Birmingham has registered only 45 hundredths of an inch, and there are a lot of places, especially across West Alabama, where it just hasn't rained much at all, whether it be August or September so far. The U.S. Drought Monitor from late last week showing what you might just call approaching drought over parts of Tuscaloosa and Bibb and Chilton County southwest, but the real drought is way down to the southwest. Been watching radar this afternoon. There have been some isolated showers and storms across the region, especially over northeast Alabama and into Georgia and East Tennessee. That's with an upper air disturbance that's tracking over toward the east of us, but our attention then begins to turn out here toward the west. As this next disturbance comes in, there's a plume of moisture here from Texas up into Oklahoma that will start to move this direction, and just a little bit of an uptick in humidity on Wednesday and Thursday could be enough to squeeze out a few isolated showers or storms. I think the greatest chance of rain on Tuesday is probably up in this zone closer to the Tennessee Valley. On Wednesday, it's probably more than likely from around Jefferson, Tuscaloosa, Chilton, down toward Montgomery, Talladega counties, and southward down toward the Alabama Gulf Coast after that. Total rainfall in the next 7 days, though, could be fairly impressive. This is the midweek showers. Not all that much to it. Some isolated pockets of rain here and there on Tuesday and Wednesday. And then we'll fast forward here and get into the weekend where it may get rather wet around here. And it's not from a storm system necessarily. It's an area of high pressure that just gets a little kink in it, and that creates a region of relative low pressure, converging air masses, and somewhere across Alabama and Georgia, a pretty good stripe of showers and a few thunderstorms will develop. The European model wants to put it right here. Conceivably, it could be as far south as Montgomery and Auburn and maybe miss Birmingham altogether. This is days and days and days worth of rainfall, so don't put too much stock into this. But if you need some rain, at least take heart in knowing that it's a possibility in the next few days. Overnight into Monday, your week's going to get started warm and humid, and it just gets hot on Monday afternoon, high close to 90 degrees. We have only a handful of days left until fall begins. 13 days left. Now, that doesn't include today, Sunday. Saturday, September 23rd, 1:50 a.m., the fall season officially begins. The average high would be about 84, the average low about 63. So let's just take a little flash forward here, shall we, and look and see what temperatures are probably going to be like leading up to that. Well, the average high about 84, the average low about 62-ish between September 16th and September 20th. Probably how this works out is the average high is probably where we are. The average lows, with drier air coming in from the north, we could end up in the 50s, so that would account for maybe 3 to 5 degrees below average across the board leading up to the first day of fall. And I think there's a good chance, a very good chance at that, that we may, by the time we get to the first day of fall, have probably seen our final 90-degree reading of the year. There's Hurricane Lee. It's strengthening again out in the Atlantic. This thing is going to track toward the west-northwest, potentially getting to Cat 4 strength again, and then by Friday of next week, it's going to be close to Bermuda. Latest forecast guidance is going to take this up into southern Canada, a near miss with the far northeast coast of the United States, and it does not look like it's going to have any major impact here across the state of Alabama. So that means for us, the weather gets pretty quiet over the next 7 days. Hot and dry on Monday, the high close to 90. Tuesday, a chance of some scattered storms. I mean, these are hit or miss. It's not going to rain everywhere, and I would hesitate to say it even rains in most places between those 2 days. We're talking about a 20 to 30% chance of any one spot getting wet enough to measure up to about a tenth of an inch. Thursday looks dry. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we get into what I'll call just simply an unsettled weather pattern. And that means a chance of some scattered showers and storms. It could interfere with high school football as well as college football for the upcoming weekend.